chilly winter morning in Mushar dwelling. The sun has not yet set out in all its glory to shed its resplendence upon the earth. People lingering, procrastinating, shriveling beneath the tremors of cold. But these innocent children, unaffected by, oblivious to the biting cold, get ready in a snap. Frisking spiritedly towards their school, adorned in their uniforms, hopping, skipping, capering along, arrive at school, where their pals and companions await them for prayers at the school assembly. In these areas, for these children, the same comfortable circumstances did not exist till a few years back. In the important state of North India, Uttar Pradesh, the status of children's education has always been far from satisfactory. Though in 2001, approximately 18.46 million children sought admission to schools, yet the percentage of dropouts was also fairly high. Significantly high as far as girl students are concerned. Reasons are multiple, such as schools being too far away from homes, financial constraints, the compulsion of child labor in order to boost the family income, engaging adolescent girls in household chores, and the indifferent and apathetic attitude of government school teachers, etc. Two important districts of the state, Varanasi and Sitapur, were also afflicted by these problems. To join children with mainstream education, bring down the dropout rate, encourage girl-child education, and help to ameliorate the condition and level of learning in government schools. In six blocks of these two districts, PACE project was initiated in 2005 with the financial support of Dakshar and Teredes Homes, Germany. This project provides right to education and qualitative education to children, and its implementing responsibility rests upon Human Welfare Association in Varanasi and Participatory Action for Community Empowerment, that is PACE, in Sitapur. Upon the inception of this project, getting children to school was a huge challenge in itself. The significance of child education, child rights, and the noxious effects of child labor, such issues were emphatically put forth to guardians. Rallies were taken out from village to village. Street plays were performed. In places where schools were too far away, non-formal education centers were started. Gradually, 26 centers became operational in various places. Children approached these centers, albeit hesitatingly, and in a matter of days, their number grew. In these schools, children began to feel extremely comfortable. Books were provided to them by the school itself. Libraries were set up, where children have access to a variety of books. Children take out their own newspaper. Initially, these centers were constructed by the project. But upon noticing the fast increasing number of students, the community coalesced and constructed more rooms.
TGS के सहयोग से एक और समुदाय के सहयोग से तीन रूम का निर्माण हुआ है और वर्तमान में एक से आठ तक की मान्यता हो गई है और बाकी कक्षाओं की मान्यता की फाइल लगी है.
As the strength of the students grew, so did the number of teachers. Now, the remuneration of these additional teachers are also borne by the community. TDH monitors and evaluates various components of the project so as to ensure and maintain its quality. The construction of lavatories for girl students has seen a noticeable increase in the number of female students. Most of the children from these centers have started going to government schools. They are now connected to mainstream education. There are still obstacles in the path of girl education after standard 8th in these areas. Too much distance between schools and homes can terminate further education. Under the project, education assistance centers have been opened for these girls. Here, girls study subjects like English, science, and mathematics. A few girls from these centers are seeking higher education.
मैं कक्षा 8 पढ़कर घर पे बैठी थी, पढ़ने का मौका नहीं मिला. इसके बाद जब सेंटर खुला, तब सेंटर में पढ़ाई करने के बाद फिर हाई स्कूल का फॉर्म ढीला प्राइवेट, अब इसके बाद पढ़ के अब रेगुलर पढ़ रही हूं इंटर.
Buildings of government schools be restored and renovated. Studies be made more appealing and the overall development of students. All these are also prime objective of this project. Suitable buildings have been constructed for some schools. Students have been provided with benches and tables. Now children come to school in tidy uniforms. Inspirational quotes have been inscribed on walls. Classes have been decorated with teaching learning material. Paraphernalia for extracurricular activities has been provided. Habits such as washing hands and mouth before meals and sitting in neat queues to eat have been adopted by the children. Training programs for teachers held at regular intervals have proved highly fruitful. These programs have not only added to the potential of teachers but have also helped to widen their outlook.
भी समय समय पर हमारे यहाँ कार्यक्रम कराते रहते हैं जिसके कारण बच्चों में और अभिभावकों में एक रुचि जगी है कि हम अपने बच्चों को हीरपुर भेजें और अच्छी से अच्छी शिक्षा लें.
सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि हमारे यहाँ स्कूल से बच्चा एक बार अगर एडमिशन ले लिया तो वो छोड़ के बीच से नहीं जाता है. जितने कोई भी बच्चा ड्रॉप आउट नहीं होता है और एडमिशन ही होते जा रहे हैं. और मुझे लगता है कि ऐसा सुधार सभी स्कूलों में होना चाहिए, सभी गाँव में होना चाहिए और स्पेस संस्था को वहाँ भी जाना चाहिए ताकि जितना हमारे स्कूल में सुधार हुआ है उतना वहाँ भी हो.
गर्ल स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ द स्कूल हैव फॉर्म्ड मीना मंच. दे मीट वंस अ मंथ टू डिस्कस टॉपिक्स सच एज हेल्थ, एजुकेशन एंड चाइल्ड राइट्स.
ने मेरी शादी तय कर दी है, तब हम लोग मीना मंच वाली सदस्य सब लोग गए उनके घर, कहा कि इसकी शादी मेरी सहेली की शादी मत करो, अभी 18 साल से उम्र से कम है. तो उनकी मम्मी ने कहा कि तुम्हारी तो सहेली, मेरी तो बेटी है, तो तुमसे क्या मतलब हम करें शादी, चाहे ना करें तुमसे क्या मतलब, हम शादी करेंगे. तब सारे हम सब सदस्य वाले हम सब ने अपने गाँव में कहा तो उन्होंने सब लोग ने जोर किया, तब उनकी शादी कैंसिल हो गई.
The positive changes in government schools is the outcome of tireless efforts and better coordination with the stakeholders like village head and Education Department by the organizations implementing this project.
गांव पंचायत पे संस्था और शिक्षा विभाग के सहयोग से उस जज्जर विद्यालय का हमने जीर्णोद्धार 2006 जनवरी में उसका उद्घाटन किया गया। उसमें दो भूकंप आरोधी कमरा हैं बनाए गए नए और रसोई घर भी बना है, जो आज विद्यालय एक मॉडल के रूप में उसमें बच्चे शिक्षा ले रहे हैं।
मैं पेश योजना के अंतर्गत कार्य करने वाले सभी गांव में बार बार बुलाई गई और मैं वहां पे मैंने विजिट भी किया। मैंने देखा कि ये योजना जहां भी चली है, इससे गांव के लोगों को बड़ी जागरूकता मिली है और ये योजना एक तरह से गांव के लोगों को आगे बढ़ाने में बहुत सफल रही है।
Another major objective of this project is to make girls self-reliant. To implement this, vocational training centers are being run. Here girls are taught stitching. Computer training is provided. Beautician courses are also run. Girls are taught to make soft toys. Painting courses are also available. Some girls who have undergone training at these centers have become independent.
मैंने ख्वाजा गरीब नवाज में एक साल सिलाई सेंटर में जाकर सिलाई सीखा। उससे हमें ये फ़ायदा हुआ कि घर के कपड़े भी सिल लेते हैं और जो बाहर से आते हैं एक दो जोड़े वो भी सिल लेते हैं, उससे हमें सिलाई मिल जाती है।
पेस प्रोजेक्ट फंक्शनल सिंस द लास्ट 5 years has not only awakened the desire for learning among children but has also brought about a pivotal change in their families.
बाल मजदूरी को रोकने के लिए इस योजना के माध्यम से एक व्यापक आधार हम लोग को मिला, जिससे आज की तारीख में बड़े पैमाने पे बच्चे शिक्षा की मुख्यधारा से जुड़ करके और तालीम लेने का काम, पढ़ाई करने का काम कर रहे हैं और सरकार अब अपनी योजनाओं को और अच्छे विस्तार ढंग से लागू कर रही है।
After joining self-help groups, the mother of these children have improved their economic status. They have stalled their children away from child labor and motivated them to go to school. Several children associated with this project from its inception now stand firmly on their feet. For continual increase of these growing imprints, the community requires complete empowerment. For this, agriculture, their main source of livelihood, should be made more sustainable and environmental improvement be focused on.
Second phase mein hum log education to sustainability ki baat kar rahe hain, जिसमें हमें ये महसूस हुआ कि थोड़ा सा जो बच्चों को पर्यावरण के प्रति जागरूक और संवेदित करने की आवश्यकता है, जिस तरह से आजकल मौसमी बदलाव आ रहे हैं, ग्लोबल वार्मिंग की सिचुएशंस है या जो पर्यावरण के हराश की बात हो रही है, उसके प्रति बच्चों, शिक्षकों और समुदाय तीनों को ही जागरूक करने की आवश्यकता महसूस हो रही है और इसे देखते हुए हमने आगे पर्यावरण शिक्षा को शामिल किया है ताकि हमारी आगे आने वाली पीढ़ी पर्यावरण के प्रति जागरूक हो, संवेदित हो, उसके महत्व को समझे और उसके संवर्धन के लिए आगे प्रयासरत हो।
The lamp of knowledge shines bright and follow the Indian tradition of lighting one candle from another. Several lamps have been lit. The light of learning seeks to be spread far and wide.